Hello, everyone. So, this is a rookie point of view, the Hollywood Fallacy Talk. And my name's Raquel Milligan. I'm going into my senior year at Baldwin Wallace University. I'm a computer network security major. And I guess just a little background about me. I've had two internships now. One was at OE Connection for a few months where I got introduced into there being a side of security that focused on physical security and social engineering, and I absolutely fell in love with that aspect and ended up getting an internship at SecureState where I'm at currently, and getting to get experience and learn about that whole side of security. I was in the Coast Guard for 5 years, loved doing law enforcement and things like that while I was in, and that's what kind of drove my passion for pursuing a career in this field. So, pass off to you.
My name is Jonathan Cartwright, and I'm also a computer networking and security major. I just graduated from BW. I've spent a little bit of time in the Army and went on to intern for both the Department of Veterans Affairs and DDR Corp. So, prior to this big change in my life, I was in management, both restaurant and some other management jobs throughout my life. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about that aspect and what my viewpoint is, which is a little bit different than Raquel's. And then the other part of it is I'm really not the smartest person in this room. I'm kind of I'm more of a people person, and I'm on the people aspect of security, and that's where I like to be. So, and then just a little bit about me personally. I've got the body shape for bar sports, you know, pool, darts, competitive drinking, that kind of stuff. So that's a bit about me.
So to get into the, I guess, gist of the title of the talk, the Hollywood Fallacy portion, the purpose of that was because prior to starting a degree at Baldwin Wallace in computer security, I had absolutely no idea how computers really worked. I'd use it for doing stupid things like paper assignments or going on the internet for social networking sites and stuff like that. But other than that, I didn't know what a command line was, didn't know anything intricate about a computer or how it worked. And movies and TV tend to make computer type work look extremely badass, for lack of better words. It's usually red team side stuff they're showing. And it always appears to be really easy and simple. They press a few buttons on a computer screen, hit enter, and magically they're hacking into systems that show them stuff that half the time that's not even really what you would get as a result from doing the type of stuff they're, trying to do. And so it made an impression on me that going into this field and going into the degree, it was going to be this easy transition to do. I was going to learn, you know, very easily how to do this stuff. And it was a rude awakening very early on in the degree program at BW that this isn't easy. And I guess makes sense because that's why, you get paid good money to do these kinds of jobs normally. And a lot of the jobs that appear to be out there for people getting ready to graduate are a lot of times actually on blue team side. There's a lot of defensive work rather than the offensive stuff. So that's also kind of where Hollywood kind of misconstrues the reality of what's out there for work. You never see someone, you know, sifting through Splunk logs on TV or movies. It's never, you know, ever something like that. So, yeah, if you want to.
I wanted to touch a little bit more on the Hollywood aspect is the fact that we always see the same things. A lot of those are people are always hacking directly into the mainframe from the website. And, you know, as we know, that's not generally the case if you're smart. So, I mean, Edward Snowden would have made it nowhere if that was what he was doing. I mean, these big exploits and these things that happen come with, you know, inside knowledge and that sort of thing. Another thing, you know, that's a fallacy is the fact that we're all, you know, stuck in the basement somewhere and, you know, this is all we do 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and never really come out unless it's to feed or, you know, that's about it. So, you know, we are all actually people and, you know, that's one of the other fallacies. You know, I mean, we all you know, have seen that. And we're working away from that quite rapidly, and that makes me happy. Another thing here, if I can touch my notes. Oh, no. Okay, I guess I can't. you know, that we constantly see is that, you know, hacking is illegal. You know, that's always portrayed as, you know, this bad thing that's out there, and, you know, all these people are above the law, and that's kind of stuff. And with that is these big, grandiose computer systems that, you know, don't get me wrong, they have their place. You know, I mean, you're not going to be, you know, doing some brute forcing with a laptop. You know, you're going to need some specialized, you know, computing power to get those things done. But the other part of it is, you know, a lot of this isn't as specialized as anybody would think. I mean, we can all download Kali, and, you know, we've got a pretty decent tool set to go ahead and start out in our career. So, with that said, I'm going to go ahead and give it to Raquel here for some of the reality portion.
So I guess a number, like, not number one question, but a top question we get asked as either interns or people interviewing for internships and things like that nature, or even jobs for someone like John, is, well, what do we do as college students, and what are we being exposed to? So we came up with a brief list of some of the things we've been exposed to or participated in ourselves. It's a lot of capture the flag type competitions that we as BW students get involved in. Mainly taking place, obviously, online on a system where you're completing certain things either individually or on a team, such as NCL, National Cyber League, to therefore earn flags and get points and, you know, win stuff for placing and things like that. Collegiate Cyber Defense Competition, CCDC, which takes place one time a year, is the more bigger deal competition someone like students at BW prepare for. It's very selective on who gets to even participate in it, and it's probably one of the more realistic cyber competitions we anyways get to see, where you're mimicking working in a very, like, a smaller scale company, and you come in and your job is to defend a small network from people in, you know, hacking into and doing things like that. So you have to keep systems up and running to score points as a team. And Secure State Capture the Flag is something we just participated in recently. And the one thing I want to point out about that is the fact that it was the first Capture the Flag I know I have participated in where physical security and social engineering were actually topics and, you know, questions we were actually having to work through and deal with. I've never seen any other Capture the Flag with those categories involved, so it was really nice to actually get exposure to, besides a classroom with somebody standing up talking about it, getting to see if you can pick a lock and see if you can, you know, talk your way into getting information you shouldn't have. So yeah, it's pretty much that.
CCDC is different in the fact that your traditional CTF is set up, you know, as a series of tasks, and you go ahead and you blow those out, and you get the flag for each one. Whereas CCDC is set up basically, it's a mimicked business environment, and not only do you have to protect the systems, but you're getting constant injects throughout for continuity of business. So not only are you going ahead and locking down these systems, and, you know, they're pretty much, you know, baseline and open, and the premise is the fact that you've taken over for an IT staff that's been fired for the most part. So it's a lot more real world, but they're both highly compartmentalized. And, you know, the fact that you've got a team and you've got, you know, different people on that team that are specialized to do certain things. So just to say that I've been there doesn't mean that necessarily I'm, you know, a master of all trades, you know, or all things that have been there. So
yeah, we definitely trained very individually for that. You know, having a e-commerce site and things like that, the point, instead of like gaining, you know, flags through answering Jeopardy type style questions or something like that, it's very much so more real world based. And also the biggest distinguisher, where something like a Capture the Flag doesn't have anybody like working against you necessarily and things like of that nature, there's a red team with actual people that some here may have been a part of, I'm not sure, where we're actually in real time being attacked by real people who work out in the field. So it's, you're actually being legitimately tested rather than answering questions that were predetermined and things like that. Yeah, absolutely. So, to get into a different next portion of the talk, it kind of, someone like me anyways have noticed there seems to be, there's somewhat of a disconnect between what we are learning in school and what's expected of us to know when we are working or applying for jobs and things like that. So, classroom setting versus workplace setting. I know most of you can, you know, think back to this and probably attest to that. There's definitely a difference between sitting in a classroom and you're having a professor lecture on something versus you're going out into the real world and actually expected to do this for a company, and it actually matters what you're doing and things like that. Problems can occur if you screw things up and things of that nature. And not just from my own experience, but from even talking to other people who are currently in internships from multiple different schools and things like that, there's a lot of us who agree that, you know, you get assigned a project or task or something like that to complete, and a lot of us find ourselves either using Google a lot more than we would like to be using it, or you're constantly bothering your mentor, somebody you're working with, because you've never had exposure to something they're asking you to do, and it's like, you don't want to necessarily be the one going up to them, you just hired me for this internship, I have no idea how to do this thing you just expected me to do, but there was no exposure to this in school, so you're basically expecting them to teach you something you feel like you know, should have learned in a school-type setting, but we're not learning that. And then, you know, the classroom exposure, which is kind of like what I just talked about, but also a lot of people saying, and I would agree with this, that school really can't fully prepare you. It's like impossible with everyone who probably knows this changes so much day in and day out. We're constantly having to adapt to the different threats, vulnerabilities, all these things that are constantly being, you know, coming up as different things all the time. It's impossible for school to keep up with this and have run a curriculum. So, you know, it's not really anything to say bad about school. It's just impossible for them to keep up with.
Well, part of the frustration in that for us as students comes from the fact that we're in an idealized setting coming out of school and, you know, into an internship or a first job. So, you know, where we may have had hands-on with Windows 7 and, you know, the business is still, has an XP box somewhere running around, and, of course, it ends up on our plate to take care of. You know, the expectation is that, you know, we should see this and we haven't. Or, you know, part of the expectation is for us coming, you know, into the field is the fact that a lot of us are hungry. You know, we want to keep moving on and move forward with our careers as fast as we possibly can. However, business edict or the budget or whatever it happens to be out there is a roadblock to that. So it's frustrating in the fact that we've all been in positions that, for whatever reason, from the top down, something isn't exactly the way we think that it should be or the right way. You know, and it could be the budget or just the fact that somebody in the C-suite says, no, we're going to go ahead and do it. What would tentatively be wrong? And as much as you argue and fight against that, it's still happening beyond you. So being able to accept that and move on, you know, as far as you put in your input and you move past it, is something that we're all struggling with learning at this point.
So this was incorporated into the slide after we did a presentation at NEOISF, for those of you who attend or have heard of that. We got a question about, well, what does BW's program look like? So we just kind of, I mean, long scheme of things, this doesn't matter, but it's, you know, as you can see, it's a combination between communications, math, business, very small business, but, and then computer science courses. And the biggest thing that I know he and I wanted to touch on is the fact that an internship is required as part of our degree. You're required to do one and write a paper and then make a presentation on it. So we are required to be sure we're actually taking something from an internship, not just going somewhere to earn money or something like that. You know, we're expected to come back to the school, share what we learned, and therefore they're able to hear these things that we're being exposed to and learning. And if that seems to be the direction, like the network security is going in or things like that, they can incorporate that into the program, change classes up to be actually matching we need to know, I guess, at this point to be successful. And
okay. With all this said, and you know, all this, well, basically student whining we've been doing, we want to talk to you about a little bit about closing the gap between students and employment, in the fact that there's definitely this part of it's generational gap, in the fact that we learn differently than what we did 30 years ago. And those expectations haven't necessarily changed from the point that whoever may be hiring us went through school versus the way we learned and what happened there. So you know, we may or may not find ourselves in a mentorship role officially. Sometimes in my coursework and my work life, I've just been thrown at somebody and they really didn't expect me and had no idea what they were supposed to be doing with me. So, you know, if we go ahead and kind of use the adage, you know, that it takes many hands, you know, to raise a child in a village, sort of, you know, thing, you know, and take people under our wing and take some sort of stewardship, you know, for these, you know, for the development of the future generations behind us, it definitely benefits us. The other part of it is I've had a big problem in my life in management trying to stop people from making the same mistakes I've made. As frustrating as it is, I've tried to choke that back, and I've almost got it completely stomped out of my life. But failure is the best tool that we have. We need to let those around us fall on their face occasionally. You know, whenever, you know, of course, you know, business demands it, we've got to be, you know, 100% uptime all the time. And that might not necessarily be the best for where we're working together forward as a team. So, you know, for us to fall on our face once in a while is probably the best learning tool we can get. Another thing I wanted to touch on is, there's been a lot of impatience in the fact that, with that compartmentalized exposure we get in school, the expectation for us to have this knowledge, you know, at the snap of a finger, be able to pull it out and solve an issue, it's in there somewhere. It may take us a minute to get there, and that requires some patience, from those that mentor us. So, I liken it to, when you were a little kid, you remember your parents told you to go clean up your room and you crammed everything that you had underneath the bed, in a drawer, the closet, wherever it happens to be. And 3 or 4 days later, you try to find your favorite thing and you know it's in there, but you just don't know where. It's the same way college works. You cram all this knowledge and information into your brain and it might take a minute for it to dawn on you of, oh, hey, I know that. So that's where the patience parts come from. Another thing I wanted to touch on was involving, you know, the intern or the new hire in some of the decision making or the problem solving that's going on, because there could be valuable input there from those people that, you know, number one, they just came fresh out of school. A lot of times we've seen the newest thing that has come out, you know, or touched base on it and might have some actual valuable input. The other part of it is in the problem solving aspect. I had a great mentor at the Department of Veterans Affairs. Something would go down and the first thing that he would do before any problem solving began was turn to me and, what do you think? So, and that was a great thing in the fact that, you know, I got to go ahead and throw my 2 cents in and, you know, see if my line of thought was, you know, right on where I needed to be as far as troubleshooting goes. And then the tail end of it is we all celebrate success. You know, hey, we're down, we're back up, this is it. You know, there's some glad handing, whatever happens, especially if it was some terrible problem. And that's the end of it. And we don't need to let that stop there. We need to circle back and find out exactly why something was down and go ahead and discuss that success further, and do some cleanup and some follow up on it, some after action. So, that's about all I have for this one.
And, one of the big points we wanted to like hit home with is not being able to stress enough how important the on-the-job training is. As I mentioned before, school does not have the ability to necessarily keep up with everything rapidly changing and going on as it is, and there's nothing really that can teach you faster or actually make stuff sink in more than actually doing this in a real-world setting where you're doing it for a company, it actually matters, you know, you're doing this for a real reason, not just earning a grade in a classroom. On-the-job training, and realistically, I'm talking about internships. I think they're extremely necessary when it comes to trying to bridge this gap. Also, another thing that was brought up is what motivates college students when it comes to applying for certain companies when it comes to internships? And besides the obvious answer of money, it's, you know, I know one of the first things I look at when I see a job posting for an internship or anything of that nature, it's when you see the requirements, it's do I meet those or can I fulfill the requirements they're even looking for? Do I have the background, classes, knowledge to even have a chance at being successful in this? And some of that falls onto companies too to ensure, you know, you guys are pushing out not just what you would idealistically like to see, but what you actually legitimately expect from someone you're pulling into a new job or internship. You don't want to be falsely leading. You could be turning away possible good candidates by doing that because I was actually reading a recent study in a information security magazine that talked about
Hi folks, I'm Geek here. Unfortunately, we had a video snafu, and we don't have any audio up until about the 24-minute, 9-second mark. Sorry for the difficulties.
Right off the bat at my first internship, you know, I got thrown into, you know, this entire world of Active Directory. Never saw anything. And that was prior to my BW career, which I picked up a little bit of it there. But, that was my associate's level, internship and never saw any of it. I would like to see more exposure to some of the tools that are being used in the real world versus the theory that's behind them. Because the theory is great. If I don't understand the theory behind it, I can't use the tool. I get that. However, to be, you know, to have some of these things dropped on you day one, and again, that's where that expectation gap is of, hey, you know, you've got a bachelor's degree in networking. You should have seen XYZ tool, and it was just something that was covered, you know. And it could be anything from, you know, like we studied Palo Alto, you know, and, you know, some other company, you know, some companies using a different firewall, and, you know, somebody feels we should have seen it. Well, there's, yeah, I get the theory. Some of the stuff transfers over, some of it doesn't. I'm not going to walk into it. Just like walking into any other job. I mean, you walk into a new IT job, so, you know, you quit one day and you pick up the next one the next. You've got a learning curve. You know, just from the things that they're different that, you know, one company does that yours doesn't, or that your new one doesn't, you know, versus the new one. You know, or, you know, tools or whatever it happens to be. So, you know, more exposure I would like to see across the board just to, you know, yeah, more real world tools and, you know, what other things may be applied. So, but that's about it for me. What about you?
Definitely real world tools like that. And also a little more on the Linux side of things. It would have been nice to have like an intro to Linux or some type of course that really focused and hit home with that. Because some of the things we do use in school do go into using, you know, we'll put a Linux operating system on a VM or something like that. But for someone like me anyways, you know, some of the people in the class do just fine with getting thrown into that. They've been messing around with that, you know, for a long time now. Someone like me goes, what the heck is this? I have no idea what we're doing. And the exposure is very, it's, you know, here's something on the screen, just copy that and do that. But I don't have the understanding of why we're doing that, why this works that way, or, you know, just, so something like that would have been really nice and helpful due to the fact that it appears there's a lot of stuff done in Linux, so.
Anybody else? Yes, sir. That would be fantastic. And I've been in some, you know, I would like to see it to be more of a 60-40 type relationship in that regard and would be very happy with it. I had some education at CSU before I transferred to BW. And their internship program model was very unique in the fact that you'd go for a couple of years and then you'd take a year and go to the internship for an entire year, and they wouldn't allow you to go to classes. So you couldn't kill both with one stone. So, I mean, almost if they did it like a vocational ed, where you spent half the day at one, half the day at the other. I mean, and I know that's a little unrealistic in the fact that, you know, we've got to work and all that kind of stuff, you know, and life takes over. But that would be much better in the fact that then if I could immediately apply what I just learned, I'd be so much better off. You know, rather than I couldn't tell you, you know, the first three or four things from, you know, networking 101 classes, you know, 3 years ago. What, how am I going to recall that? I mean, it's just the expectation is weird for me to jump out and just go get certified. That's kind of nutty, you know, without any practical application. So that would be a great program. I'd love to see stuff like that happen. Anyone else? All right. Thank you very much.